Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 291 to 300. This is the part 15th of top 300 MCQ of Indian Evidence Act. Now starting here. Question number 291. The cross-examine on answer to court question is available. Option A here. To the adverse party only, to the party calling the witness only, either of parties with a leave of court, none of the above. In this question, the cross-examine on answer to court question is available to both type of party, adverse party and calling party. So with the permission of court. So option C is correct here. Question number 292. The privilege to withhold documents information under administrative law is option A section 140, option B section 153, option C section 123, option D section 127. So section 140 is provided the witness to character, and such character the witness may be cross-examined or re-examination in this section. So section 153 provide that the exclusion of evidence contradict to question testing veracity of the witness. So here the testing veracity. Veracity of witness. So question section 123 provide the evidence as to affair of state. So affair of state. Of state. And last one option here, 127. This section provides the section 126 to apply to interpreter, etc. So in this question, the documents information under administrative law is withhold the getting the privilege. So under section 123, any document which is not officially published, the state getting the privilege, the no one have a capability to produce a such document which are not published by the state. So question number 293. The communication made without prejudice has been provided under which section of the Evidence Act 1872? Section 22, section 24, section 23, section 27. So in this question, 23 is here answer, because the answer is communication made without prejudice has been provided under which section of. So communication without prejudice provided under section 23 of Evidence Act. Question number 294. The necessity rule as admissibility of evidence has been given under which section of the Indian Evidence Act, necessity rule. It is very clear here answer. Section 5B, section 33, section 32, section 31. So in this question, necessity rule as admissibility of evidence is provided under section 32 of Evidence Act. The 32 of Evidence Act provided that the person who is the statement of given by the person who is dead or incapable to come before the court, and a person who is not found, or a person who is belong to a remote area is not availability of proper cost and to in the court. So option C is correct in this question. Question number 295. The case of Pakla Narayan Swami versus Emperor, the pertaining to estoppel, dying declaration, hostile witness, accomplice evidence. So it is clear here. Option B is correct, dying declaration. The Pakla Narayan Swami versus Emperor is a leading case of dying declaration under section 32 of Evidence Act. Question number 296. An admission under section 17 of Indian Evidence Act. Orally, only oral or documentary oral documentary or statement containing electronic form. Three term: oral, documentary and electronic form. Statement contained in electronic form and none of the above. So the admission under section 17 in form of oral, in form of documentary and a statement containing electronic form. So option C is correct here. Question number 297. Burden as to proof of ownership has been contemplated in which section of Evidence Act 1872? Section 118, section 110, section 102, section 101. So section 118 provided that option 18 provided that who may testify. 18 provide who may testified. So to testify, a person who has understand the question. First one, understand the question, and second one is important point here, and giving the rational answer of such an question which is asked by the parties. So section 18 provide this thing, and section 110 burden of proof as ownership. So section it is ownership. So burden of proof as to ownership, section 10 is provided here. Section 102, it is very important. Section 102, it is provide the provision of onus provendi, yani onus of proof means onus of proof. And last one section here, 101, this is also very important question section. This section provide the burden of proof. Burden of proof is always in criminal case on the prosecution, and in civil case on the a person who is file the case or institute the case. So in this question answer is 110, option 100, section 110 of Evidence Act, the burden of proof of ownership. So I write here ownership, so option B is correct. And the section 118, the testify who may testify, and this is onus of proof, onus provendi is also called. And option 101 section provide that the burden of proof. Question number 298, the test identification parade. Yes, test identification parade, the conducted during investigation of case is admissible in Evidence Act under section of Evidence Act, section 5, section 9, section 10, sorry, section 9, section 8 and section 14. So section 5 provided that the evidence may be given of fact in issue or relevant fact. So it is provided that fact in issue or relevant fact. And section 9 provided that identity of person, then person. Section 8 provided that MPC, motive, preparation and conduct, such conduct is subsequent conduct and previous conduct. And section 14 provided that the fact showing the existence of state of mind and body or bodily feeling. Bodily feeling. So in this question, the identification parade. So it is clear here, section 9, the identifying of person. So option B is correct. Question 299. Under which section of Indian Evidence Act 1872, the opinion of examiner of electronic evidence is relevant fact? So it is clear here, option A is correct. Section 45A, opinion of examiner of electronic evidence is relevant. Question number 300. Which one of the following is correctly matched under Indian Evidence Act 1872? The burden of proof under section 101. I previously explained these sections. So it is correct here. burden of proof under section 101. Accomplice under section 116, it is wrong, it is 133. It is also wrong, it provided under section 109. Yes, it is also wrong here. It is provided that 113B. So, which statement is correct? So the statement is correct, option A, burden of proof under section 101 of Evidence Act. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel and share. Don't forget to share this video. Okay, thank you.